Turtles have arguably some of the most unusual body plans in the animal kingdom, but have you ever wondered what's inside a turtle shell? Small hatching turtles often have a fairly soft shell, but these tend to harden in the first few days or weeks of life. The shells themselves have several layers which can include bone, live tissues, and cartilage. A unifying feature for most species is an outer layer of scutes, which are made of keratin, a strong, fibrous structural protein that makes everything from horns to even human nails and hair. Strong though it may be, the shell can still be sensitive to touch, which may explain why some tortoises tend to dance when under falling water. The shell is actually part of the turtle's skeleton. They can heal moderate injuries, but if the shell is severely damaged, it's unlikely they'll survive, as their internal organs will be exposed. The dome on top, known as the carapace, has a bony inner lining that fuses to the animal's backbone. The plastron, which is the flat bit on the turtle's belly, is also bony and fuses with the animal's rib bones and sternum. Not all of the turtle's skeleton is on the outside though, as its shoulders and hip girdles actually sit inside the shell. This makes land-dwelling turtles such as tortoises unique, as they're the only terrestrial vertebrates strutting around with their hips and shoulders basically tucked inside their ribs. The bone in the shell of many, if not all species, is lightweight. Most of the weight of even a really large tortoise seems to come not from the shell, but more from what's inside it. Things only get weirder as we start to look at how these animals breathe. Their lungs are positioned towards the top and front of the carapace, a very handy adaptation that allows all turtles, even the chunky land tortoises, to float. This talent is thought to have been pivotal in these shelly reptiles colonizing oceanic islands such as the Seychelles, Mauritius, and Galapagos. The only downside of these shell-encased lungs is that, since the turtle's ribs have become fused and keratinized, it can't rely on negative pressure in the chest cavity to pull air into its lungs. The turtle has two alternatives here. It can use a muscle sling that's attached to its shell as a means of drawing air in and out, or it can use its butt. This physiological wonder is performed via one of nature's most versatile structures, the cloaca. This all-peeing, all-pooping, and all-egg-laying super orifice helps turtles excrete all manner of things. But for turtles, it can also be used to take in oxygen and dump carbon dioxide. This happens as aquatic turtles take water in via the cloaca, where gas exchange occurs and the water is released again. Inside a turtle's shell is a unique structure that comes into play when some turtles, like the painted turtle, switch from aerobic to anaerobic respiration while hibernating underwater. In this state, the turtles use glucose instead of airborne oxygen and release lactic acid. Too much acid is a problem for the snoozy turtle, so its shell absorbs the acid and releases bicarb to neutralize it, in the same way that taking an antacid can neutralize acid reflux in humans. Things return to a more conventional body plan when you look at the internal organs of turtles, which sit between its bony lower plastron and lungs. Here you'll find the digestive and reproductive systems, as well as the heart, liver, and kidneys. Thank you for watching IFL Science. Please subscribe for more science videos.